Hi friends, today Paramprit Kaur Sidhu from Kanika's Nursing Academy will discuss about NCLEX.
Good morning to all of you. My name is Paramprit Kaur Sidhu. Today I am going to give a brief information about NCLEX examination. The full form of NCLEX examination is National Council Licentiate Examination. This is a nationwide examination which is based on the education of nurses that is applicable in United States in 1994 and in Canada in 2015. And this test is applicable in Canada for different 10 provisions only. It is not applicable for all over Canada. Basically, the purpose of this test is to get the license as a nursing in the nursing field so that we can do a job in hospital. Without this particular license, the nurse is not eligible to function as a nurse in hospital. The hospital can be any, that is medical hospital or psychiatric hospital. Next, there are different types of the license. Basically, the license of this test is divided into three types. First is registered nurse. And next is practical nurse, or we can say vocational nurse, and you can also apply for registered psychiatric nurse. And next is the skills assessed in the NCLEX examination. They assess the different skills. They assess our knowledge, our cognitive skills, and our theoretical knowledge, which we have to apply in the practical field. And next is the prerequisites. What are the requirements to give the NCLEX examination? First is, we must have graduation degree in nursing field from affiliated university. And second is, IELTS, whose first language is not English. For example, whose first language is Punjabi or Hindi, they have to give the English provisional test so that they can apply for their NCLEX examination. Instead of IELTS, there is also another test, that is Selborne. We can give this test in Canada only. This test is applicable in Canada only. If we haven't given the IELTS as an English proficiency test, we can give Selborne in Canada. The band requirement in IELTS is different in different states. Like in Canada, the band requirement is 7 each and 7.5 in listening. The scores for Selborne is different, but in United States, the IELTS requirement is less as compared to Canada, that is 6.5 each. But California is a state where there is no IELTS requirement. We can give the exam for California without IELTS. And next, there is a NNAS. This is a governing body in Canada. They assess our documents according to our education. They get a report and they review the particular report. They verify our documents from our university, from our college, or from our job area. And after reviewing the document, when they feel that we are eligible to give this test, then only they permit us to give the test. And this is CGFNS. This is the governing body in USA. Same, the task is same as MNS that they are doing in Canada, but for US there is CGNFS. You can visit this site, that is mnas.ca, to get the handbook of this organization so that you can read details about this examination. Thank you.